Hello folks, so this is the continuation of previous video where I gave an introduction of Google Collaboratory. So Google Collaboratory or Google Colab provides free GPU and TPU machines on cloud, as we know, and with the help of which we can train our deep learning neural networks free of cost. So it provides Jupyter notebooks where you can write your deep learning based Python code and run it. So it would take only minutes to train your deep learning models. And in this video, I'm going to extend the discussion and cover other important topics in this regard. So I'm going to show you how to run bash commands, how to upload local files, as well as install libraries, etc. Folks, this is Nitin, who is on a mission to democratize the artificial intelligence, big data, Hadoop, cloud computing, and blockchain to the entire world. And with this aim, I'm creating the associated content and publishing it on the periodic basis in order to make it available for the entire community who wants to learn these modern technologies. And you can subscribe to my channel or press the bell icon to keep on getting latest updates regarding hottest technologies of 21st century. You can also follow me on Twitter as well as on Facebook at the link given above. Okay. And I have also added the subtitles in the languages like Hindi, English, and French for your convenience. So you can add or enable them as per your needs. So let's get started. First up in the list is how to mount the Google Drive. Okay. And please note that I would be sharing this Jupyter notebook with all the commands listed out there. So you can refer it later on. So let me open this Google Colab Jupyter notebook and run a few commands. In fact, the set of commands to mount the Google Drive. Okay. So here is my Jupyter notebook. Let me, in fact, open a new Python 3 notebook. So as you can see, the Jupyter notebook has opened. Okay. And you can change the runtime type. So right now it is none mentioned here. You can change it to GPU or TPU, whatever. So let's run these set of commands. In fact, okay, press shift enter. So once this set of commands gets run, it will ask you to enter the verification code. So you can click on this link. Okay, so it will open a new tab, okay, and it will ask you to enter your login details. Okay, so you can just log in here using your Google account. It will take certain permissions here, so you allow it. Okay, and now it provides you the code, so you can just copy this code. Okay. And the way I copied is just click on this code and click on this particular button here, copy button, and then paste it here. Okay. So it will again ask you to open the following URL in web browser. Click once again on there. Okay. It will again ask you for your login credentials. Okay, so click on your login details. Click on allow. And then once again, you just copy this code. Okay, and paste it here. And now you can see the message. Okay, access token retrieved correctly. So the next command of next set of commands we need to run in the second cell. Okay, so you need to run these commands. Okay, and you can see this exclamatory mark. So whenever we want to run any bash commands, we prefix that bash command with exclamatory mark, whether it is a listing directory ls command, or you know, make directory command, or copy command, something of that sort. So whenever you want to you know, run any bash command, you just need to prefix it with exclamatory mark. So here we are creating the directory. Okay, so press shift enter again. So our drive is mounted now. So if you want to see the content of your mounted drive, you can just, you know, run this command, which is again a bash command. So ls for listing the directory, and this is the root directory. Content is the root directory. Then inside this we have a drive, okay, which is a mounted drive. Okay, so if you want to see the content inside this, you can just run this cell and you will see. So I have certain files and folders inside this drive. Okay, these are some of the files and directories in my drive. Okay, so this way you can, and if you want to go inside it, any specific drive, for example, I have this drive called, let us say, sorry, folder called software. So let me run this. Okay, so you can see that it is now showing the content of this particular folder, software folder. So whatever is there present in this folder, it is showing this. Okay, now let's do one more thing. Let's create a directory here. Okay, so we'll prefix it by exclamatory mark, then mkdir, and the name of the directory, which is test dir. Okay, press shift enter. Okay, so our directory is created. So if you want to see the directory, so if you want to, let us say, go inside this directory, so let us cd test dir. You are inside this library now, folder now, or directory now. Now you can see the path, complete path, using pwd command. Okay, and let's say you want to install any library, then in that case you can do so by again prefixing it with exclamatory mark. And let's say in this case I want to install a library called PrettyTable. Okay, so you can install this library, so using pip install command and name of the library. So when you press shift enter, you can see that a message saying requirement already satisfied, pretty table in this particular location. So that means this library was also already there. So had it been not there, then it could have been installed. Okay, so you can install any library using this command. Okay, now let's say you want to upload any file. So you can upload any file from your local system to Google Colab location, okay, directory location, by using these commands. Okay, so from google.colab import files, okay, and then uploaded equals to files dot upload. Okay, press shift enter. So now you are provided with this upload file option. You can just click on choose file and click on I have this file pi dash on my F drive, so I can just select this file. Okay, and you can see the message saving pi-dash.py to pi-dash.py. So that means my file is uploaded here, okay, on Google Colab. Now, if you want to see whether our file really got uploaded, and then you can just type that list directory command, and since our root directory is content, so we will type content. Okay, and you can see our pi-dash.py file. Okay, along with this you can see my mounted drive, okay, which we mounted earlier on, as well as the test dir directory which I created here, right here you can see. So here mkdir tester, so I created this directory, so you can see this directory as well which we created earlier, and my pi-dash.py file. Okay, and next up is let us say if you want to run any existing script from the collaboratory location. Okay, the directory location. So let us say this file, I want to run this pi-dash.py file. What I can do is I can just type this command exclamation mark python 3, because I'm using python 3, so python 3, and the location of this file, which is inside content. So this file is available inside content, you can see here, right? So I will give the full qualified path here for this file and then press shift enter. So essentially what I'm doing is I'm running or executing this script which is present on this location, folder location, which is slash content. Okay, so I'm giving a full qualified path of this file, python file, right? Press shift enter. Okay, so you can see it has given the error called no module name dash. So that means I need to install this dash library. So I can use pip install dash. Okay, so it will install the dash library here, as you can see very well. So this particular library was not available here, so that's why it is installing it. You can see it now. It is kind of, you can see this particular code in action, right? So you can see the message successfully installed, right? Dash is successfully installed. Let's run this command once again. Okay, and you can see that it has given the link of URL, or the URL where I can see our application. Okay, right now it may not be running, but this is the way basically you can run any Python file, okay, which is available on collaboratory. There might be some issue due to which it is not running, but yeah, you got the idea that you can run any particular script on Google Collaboratory using this kind of command, right? And in fact, if you want to see this particular code pi-dash.py in action, I have created separate videos for creating dashboards or the visualizations. So you can see over there this particular application in action. Okay, right now it is not running for Google Colab, but if you want to run it on your local system, okay, so basically what I do is, so this is not on local system right now, correct? So if you see that application, you will be able to know, okay, and this URL very well works. So whenever you watch that video, you will get complete details, and at that point in time when you run this particular program pydash.py, you will be able to see the output on browser. Okay, all right, so you can watch those separate videos of mine. All right, so folks, this is it for this video. To conclude, we learned about various commands which can be very useful when working with Google Colab. And these commands can make your day-to-day tasks easier and hence your life easy when working on this cloud environment. Okay, so here is today's question. Was this two video series helpful for you from your training deep learning models free of cost? Absolutely. Okay, so please share your comments in the comment section given below. And if you're watching this video and you are not already a subscriber to our channel, consider clicking that little subscribe button. And in case you have already subscribed, then click on bell icon to receive the notifications whenever I will release a new video. So thanks for hanging out with us, guys. I will be covering next topic in the upcoming videos. So keep on watching. Thank you.